इवन नोट्स में मैसेज देना। प्रैक्टिस प्रॉब्लम फोर। दैट इज नॉट फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन है। Equation, the pair of tangents drawn from 2 comma minus 1 to the ellipse. Point P, 2 comma minus 1, first question is it? 2 comma minus 1. Ellipse equation, x square plus 3y square is equal to 3. X square plus 3y square minus 3 is equal to 0. Okay, so how did I convert this equation into this form is? Assume this to be s is equal to 0. Okay. Ellipse equation, assume it to be s is equal to 0. The question is to find the equation of pair of tangents. Remember the formula. Equation of pair of tangents. See, we have not discussed this formula separately in ellipse, but in circles we have discussed the formula for this. Equation of pair of tangents. How to find that? S into S1, okay? S into S11 is equal to S1 square. This is the equation of pair of tangents. S into S11 is equal to S1 square. So now, how do you get this? S is x square plus 3y square minus 3. This is S. What is S11? 2 square plus 3 into minus 1 whole square minus 3, which is 3 minus 3 is 0, 4. S1, what is S1? X into 2 plus 3 into y into minus 1 minus 3. So basically it is 2x minus 3y minus 3. This is S1. So now substitute all these three values in the equation. S into S11 is equal to S1 square. Mains are 22, 23. Is the mains are one? Is that there something? No, na. PP 4 one, na. Practice problem 4 one, na. Then munda one, 3 one. Practice problem 3 one, na. 3 lo. 22, 23. Okay, chapter. Okay. So, in more this case, equation of tangent, you will get the equation of pair of tangents. See, S into S11 is equal to S1 square. This is fixed for circle, ellipse, hyperbola as well as parabola also. In more this case, parabola also. S into S11 is equal to S1 square. That is fixed. Okay. Next. Second question. X by A plus Y by B is equal to root 2 touches the ellipse. The eccentric angle theta of the point of contact is equal to. Second question. Okay. X by A plus Y by B is equal to root 2 touches x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. Okay. Now, first try to convert this. Okay, we do only x by a into 1 by root 2 plus y by b into 1 by root 2 is equal to 1. Okay. Now, x into cos pi by 4 by a plus y into sin pi by 4 by b is equal to 1. So compare this with x cos theta by a, x cos theta by a plus y sin theta by b is equal to 1. So which represents the equation of tangent? Which represents equation of tangent? So this is, so that is the equation of tangent at point P pi by 4. At point P, whose secondary angle is pi by 4? There, a cos theta by a plus y sin theta by b is equal to 1. This is the equation of tangent. Remember that? This is the equation of tangent in terms of parametric point. Okay, in terms of parameter, x cos theta by a plus y sin theta by b is equal to 1. Okay. Okay. So from this, what can you observe? This is the equation of tangent at a point P pi by 4. Now the question is, find the eccentric angle theta at the point of contact. Theta is equal to pi by 4. That is the answer. Second question. Next one. The points on the ellipse x square plus 4y square is equal to 2, where the tangents are parallel to the line. Very simple one. X square plus 4y square is equal to 2. Okay. So which means x square by 2 plus y square by 1 by 2 is equal to 1. Okay. X square by 2 plus y square by 1 by 2 is equal to 1. A square is equal to 2, b square is equal to 1 by 2. Okay, so let it be like that. Now, points on the ellipse where the tangents are parallel to, tangent parallel to x minus 2y minus 6 is equal to 0. Okay. X minus 2y minus 6 is equal to 0. So let the point be, let the point be a cos theta comma b sin theta. Okay, so everyone observe the approach here, observe the approach to the solution. What is the question? Find the point, find the point at which the tangents are parallel to x minus 2y minus 6 is equal to 0. If the question is to find the equation of tangent, the question is to find the equation of tangent to this ellipse, okay, which is parallel to this. The question is not to find a point of contact. The question is simply to find the equation of tangent parallel to this. Okay. Then you take the value of m. What is the value of m here? Half. Now the question will turn to equation of tangent to the ellipse with slope m is equal to half, which is y is equal to mx plus or minus under root a square m square plus b square. Remember the formula? Now the approach is different here because we are asked to find the points where the tangent is parallel to this. We need the points now. So let the point be a cos theta comma b sin theta. So equation of tangent actually don't need to find the equation of tangent, it is enough to find slope at this point. So slope of tangent at P, slope of tangent at point B. What is the slope observed here? Slope is equal to minus x coefficient upon y coefficient. Minus x coefficient upon y coefficient. See? Minus b by a into cot theta. Minus b by a into cot theta. See? Cos by sin. Cot. Okay? 1 by a by 1 by b. B by a with minus sin. So, slope of tangent at a point theta is minus b by a cot theta. Then the slope of tangent for the parabola at point T, it is 1 by T. Slope of normal is minus T. Okay? So remember that. Slope of tangent point B is minus B by A cot theta. What is the slope here? What is the slope? 1 by 2. Slope is 1 by 2. Now, 1 by 2 is equal to minus B by A into cot theta. What is b by a? 1 by root 2 by root 2. Cot theta is equal to minus 2a by b. So from here, a is root 2, b is 1 by root 2. So now a by b, root 2 by 1 by root 2, 2 it becomes. So minus 2 into 2, minus 4. So cot theta is minus 4. Sorry. Cot theta is minus a by 2b. 2 by 2, minus 1. So, cot theta is minus 1. When do you get cot theta minus 1? Theta should be? Yes. Where is cot negative? Cot is negative in second quadrant and fourth quadrant. So, second quadrant, pi minus pi by 4. Fourth quadrant, 2 pi minus pi by 4. Okay, there will be 2 points. So, pi minus pi by 4, 3 pi by 4, or 2 pi minus pi by 4, 7 pi by 4. Just substitute the values of theta here, a cos theta comma b sin theta, you will get the answer. Okay? Next, the points of the ellipse where the normals to it are perpendicular to 6x plus 5y. Same. Okay. Here the question was, in the third question was, where the tangents are parallel to a line. In the fourth question will be, where the normals are perpendicular to 6x plus 5y minus 2. If the normal is perpendicular to that line, observe this very carefully. If the normal is perpendicular to that line, obviously tangent will be parallel, right? If the normal is perpendicular, then the tangent will be parallel. So tangent is parallel to, again, same question. Again, same question. Next. Next one, total number of real tangents that can be drawn to the ellipse passing through passing through 3, 5. Okay. Fifth one, 3x square plus 5y square is equal to 32. Okay. 25x square plus 9y square is equal to 450. So tangents passing through is the regular question. Tangents passing through 3, comma 5. Okay. So, total number of real tangents that will be drawn to the ellipse and this one, okay, passing through 3, 5. So write the tangent equation first for both the ellipses. Write the equation of tangent x cos theta for first one, x cos theta by a plus y sin theta by b is equal to 1. Okay, similarly for the second one. So after writing that, substitute the point 3, 5 here. Okay, because tangent passes through 3, 5. Okay, write one step.
Let me solve. So first equation of tangent. See, this is vertical ellipse. Okay. Anyways, x square by 32/3 plus y square by 32/5 is equal to 1. That is the equation of ellipse. Okay. So where a square is 32/3, b square is 32/5. Equation of tangent x by a cos theta plus y by b sin theta is equal to 1. X by a cos theta plus y by b sin theta is equal to 1. So put x is equal to 3 cos theta by a. What is a? So under root 32/3 plus y. What is y? 5 into sin theta by under root 32/5 is equal to 1. So cos theta into 3√3/√32 plus sin theta into 5√5/√32 is equal to 1. So root 32 cross multiplication, 3√3 into cos theta plus 5√5 into sin theta is equal to √32. Okay, is equal to √32. Now, what is the maximum value of this? Put in the formula a cos theta plus b sin theta is equal to under root a square plus b square. Minimum value is minus under root a square plus b square. So, maximum value. Is equal to under root 3√3 whole square plus 5√5 whole square. So which will be equal to 3√3 whole square plus 5√5 whole square. This is 27, right? Obviously, tapiyaamadharanga 5√5. And tapiyaasanta jomandre okay sir. Okay, in the okay. 5√5. Friends of raise 120. Obviously, root 32 is less than root 152. Okay, root 32 is less than root 152. So two dimensions. Because from an external point, obviously, there will be two tangents possible, no doubt on that. Okay? Pass into 3, 5. Now put 3, 5 here. Put 3, 5 here. Yeah, some also rather than actually on that. Okay, put 3, 5 in this equation. 25 into 3 square minus 9 into, plus 9 into 5 square minus 450. 25 into 9 plus 25 into 9. What is 25 into 9? 25 is 200. So 225 plus 225 minus 450. 0. Actually, it's not possible. So, it's not possible. Okay. This is S11 for second ellipse. So point is on the ellipse. Point is on the ellipse. So number of tangents possible is number of tangents that can be drawn is equal to 1. Okay. Now, tangents passing through 3, 5. S11 for first ellipse. S11 for first ellipse is equal to 3 into 3 square plus 5 into 5 square minus 32. So 27 plus 125 minus 32, which is obviously greater than 0. So point is outside. Point is outside the ellipse. Okay, which means two tangents can be drawn. Okay, from an external point always two tangents can be drawn. From a point on the curve only one tangent can be drawn. From a point inside the curve no tangent can be drawn. Okay, tangent cannot be drawn from a point inside the curve. This is a point on the curve, so number of tangents that can be drawn is 1. This is a point outside the curve, so number of tangents that can be drawn is 2. Okay, so that is about fifth one. Next, sixth question is a direct question, conceptual question. Locus of point of intersection of perpendicular tangents to the ellipse is a circle with center 0, 0, which means he is talking about director circle in the question. Okay, the sixth question is talking about director circle. So what is the radius of director circle? Under root a square plus b square, that is fixed. So option D is the answer for the sixth one. Seventh one, the point of intersection of the tangents at the point P on the ellipse and its corresponding point Q on the auxiliary circle meet on the line. Okay, seventh question. Point of intersection of the tangents at point P on the ellipse. P is A cos theta comma B sin theta. Observe this very carefully. Point P on ellipse. X square by A square plus Y square by B square is equal to 1. Okay. Now what is Q? It is saying that the point Q is on auxiliary circle. On auxiliary circle, corresponding point to point P, Q is on the auxiliary circle. Okay, which is the auxiliary circle? Auxiliary circle. So this is point P. If you extend, or if you say, if you draw a line through P parallel to Y axis, it intersects the circle at point Q. Okay, that is the point he is talking about. So remember correctly. Point Q is A cos theta comma A cos theta. Sorry. A cos theta comma A sin theta. Point Q is A cos theta comma A. That is the parametric point on the circle. This parametric point on the ellipse. So what is all this equation? X square plus Y square is equal to A square. Because major axis is the diameter for the auxiliary circle. Which means X square plus Y square is equal to A square is the equation of auxiliary circle. Now equation of tangent at P. Ikkada kavali. Ikkada. Equation of tangent at the q to the circle here, here at p to the ellipse. X by a cos theta plus y by b sin theta is equal to 1. Here the equation is simply x cos theta plus y sin theta is equal to a. That is the equation of tangent to the circle at this point. And this is the equation of tangent to the circle to the ellipse at this point, at point B. Okay? So, 1, 2. Now the question is, find point of intersection of. Point of intersection of the tangents meet on the line. Okay. Find point of intersection. Find point of intersection, you get a point, and then have to check the point lies on which of the lines in the given options. Okay, there are four options given. Those are not points, those are the lines. What is the question? Meet on the line. The point of intersection, meet on the line. Okay, so basically these two lines meet on which line? So find the point of intersection first. We have to do one thing. Find the point of intersection. Obviously, you will get that in terms of theta. Then find the locus of point of intersection. Find the point of intersection and then find its locus. And then find its locus. Because theta is a parameter here, there are so many such points P and Q. So many such points P and Q, which means you get so many such tangents. You get so many such tangents, which means there are so many points of intersection. The question is, all those points of intersection meet on which line? What does that mean? All those points of intersection meet on which line means find the locus of points of intersection. Find the locus of points of intersection. Okay. So this is until 7th question. Once we'll discuss doubts from practice problems 3 also. Practice problems 3. Yeah. So 4 mallo gaile there. First 3 discuss chesi. 10 minutes left for this lecture. రే ప్రవీణం తట్టించరని చెప్పాడు కదా.
practice problem 3. G means ये क्वेश्चन का चेक करना 22 23 है. Line meets the ellipse in the points P and Q. Midpoint of chord. Let the midpoint of chord be given Lx plus My plus N is equal to 0 is, this is PQ, remember. This PQ is chord to is chord to x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to, okay. So given line PQ is chord to the ellipse. The question is find the midpoint of the chord. So find midpoint. That is the question. Find midpoint of PQ, that is the question. Now we do one thing. Let midpoint be h comma k, okay. Let the midpoint be h comma k, p comma q, whatever, x comma y, and then this question. Let the midpoint be h comma k. So we discuss this formula. If you know the midpoint, you can find the equation of chord. How? So equation of chord will be, equation of chord is S1 is equal to S11. Remember this? S1 is equal to S11. Now what is S1? X into H by A square plus Y into K by B square minus 1 is equal to, what is S11? H square by A square plus K square by B square minus 1. Minus 1, minus 1 cancel. Okay. X h by a square plus y k by b square minus of h square by a square plus k square by b square is equal to 0. That is the equation of chord. So x h by a square plus y k by b square minus of a b, okay. So suppose this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. See, question line which I know, this is the chord. In the question it is given that this is the chord. Now if you have found out, what we have found out? This is the chord equation. Assume the midpoint to h come again. Now 1 and 2, equations 1 and 2 represent same line. Represents same line. Equations 1 and 2 represent same line. So 1 by a square, compare coefficients, compare this one. First we have h by a square by L is equal to k by b square by M is equal to minus of h square by a square plus k square by b square by N. Okay, so these are you have to solve. Now from here find h and k. From here find h and k. Now h by a equate these two as well as these two. H by a, I'm giving 1a here. I'm giving 1a here only. H by a is equal to al into. suppose let this entire thing be. The mottani k and one. Let this entire thing be P, and then we'll come back to this. Now, H by A is equal to A n in the left here, cross multiplication, A n into minus P. So, minus A L into P. Next, K by B is equal to minus bm into p. Okay, h by a is equal to minus a and b, k by b is equal to minus b m b. Alright, now, okay, so squaring these two equations, h square by a square plus k square by b square, because already we have h square by a square plus k square by b square here. So that's why I'm doing this, that 3 minutes only. Okay, is equal to a square m square p square plus b square m square p square. So p square common, a square m square plus b square m square. Okay, that remains same. Okay, chapter 11. Now, h square by a square, h square by a square plus k square by b square by n is equal to p, right? So h square by a square plus k square by b square will be equal to n into p. So n into p is equal to p square into a square l square plus b square m square. So p p cancel. From here I get p is equal to n upon a square l square plus b square m square. Now what is h? H is equal to minus a square l into p. So minus a square l into p and n upon a square l square plus b square m square, whereas k is equal to minus b square mp. So minus b square m n by a square l square plus b square m square. So that is the answer. H comma k. So the point is h comma k. Midpoint is h comma k. So question number one, I is on the